Welcome back to SG Dr. Wellness. My name is Dr. Chen Yiming. For this series of 4 videos on how to reverse aging, I'm very happy to have with me 2 good friends, Dr. Elliot and Coach Alvin Ho. All 3 of us will share some tips on reversing aging. In this first video, we'll be sharing with you the physical and cellular changes in aging. In the second video, we'll be sharing how sleeping better, managing stress, and stopping smoking can help us reverse aging. In the third video, how physical exercise can make us younger, and in the final video, how our diet and nutrition can help us look younger. If you're new to our channel, click on the subscribe button now.
Now, before we start talking about how to look and feel younger, we should discuss more about aging. So what is aging? What causes aging at the cellular level? What happens physically to us when we get older? Aging is the process of becoming older. We know this. At the cellular level, there's an accumulation of cell damage with time. So as a result, there is a progressive generalized impairment of a body's function, resulting in an increasing vulnerability to external injuries and higher risk of disease and death. So physically, what happens? Our hair starts to thin, balding may occur, gray hairs start to appear. Our brain's volume peaks in the early 20s and then begins to shrink thereafter. Our eyes start to fail as we develop long-sightedness and maybe even cataracts. Aging causes hearing loss starting from the higher frequencies, and our taste perception declines too. We can detect salt as well, and our bitter taste is exaggerated. Our musculoskeletal system starts to weaken. There's a loss of muscle and bone mass with an increase in body fat. What used to be a lean, muscular, V-shaped body is now a pear-shaped, flaccid us. Our strength declines by about 1% per year, and then accelerates to about 3% after 60 years old. Wear and tear occurs in our joints, resulting in back and neck pain, hip and knee osteoarthritis. You can't carry as heavy a weight or run as fast as before. And our muscles reduce capacity to recovering from exercise and injury. Our maximum heart rate declines too, and so will our VO2 max if we don't keep up our physical training. And what about your skin, the biggest organ of our body? Our face and arms begin to develop pigmentations like sunspots, and wrinkles appear on the forehead and our corner of our eyes. Our skin thins and it starts to sag due to the loss of collagen, so some of us may not look as attractive as before. And neurologically, the blood flow to the brain decreases, so we get less efficient at recruiting different areas of our brain. So basically, your thinking slows, you can't learn as quickly. Along with your motor skills and your intelligence, you also decline. People may notice subtle abilities to not multitask as well. And sadly, it's associated with many neurological diseases like dementia and Parkinson's.
On a cellular level, what happens? Several mechanisms combine to give rise to cell aging and cell deaths. Firstly, telomere shortening. Telomeres are DNA structures shaped like a hairpin found at both ends of chromosomes. They act like a counter to ensure that cells do not divide indefinitely like cancer cells. With each cell division, the telomeres shorten until they disappear. When that happens, the cell can no longer divide and enter a stage called senescence. Leonard Hayflick and Paul Moorhead found in the early 1960s that normal human fetal fibroblasts in culture reach a maximum of approximately 50 cell population doublings before becoming senescent. We know now that telomere dysfunction accelerates the aging process, and the accumulation of senescent cells contribute to aging. So in recent years, shorter telomeres have become associated with a broad range of aging-related diseases, including stroke, dementia, cardiovascular disease, obesity, osteoporosis, diabetes, and many forms of cancer. The good news is telomere shortening can be countered by the action of telomerase, an enzyme that lengthens telomeres during each DNA replication. We'll be sharing more later on what lifestyle changes can enhance the telomerase activities and bring about lengthening of telomeres and anti-aging. Secondly, accumulation of errors in our DNA can result in aging too. The DNA sequence in our body can undergo mutation. These mutations can happen due to errors of replication during cell divisions. They can also happen due to external insults from physical, chemical, and biological agents. To minimize these errors, humans have evolved a complex network of DNA repair mechanisms and are capable of correcting most of them. However, with time, the DNA repair mechanisms start to fail too. When too much DNA error accumulates in the cell, our body will destroy that particular cell as a protective function. And when the rate of cell deaths exceeds rate of cell replication, aging occurs. Thirdly, stem cell exhaustions. The decline in the regenerative potential of tissues is one of the most obvious characteristics of aging. For example, new blood cells generation declines with age, resulting in a diminished production of immune cells and oxygen-carrying red blood cells. When our store of stem cells are gradually used up, the rate of production of new cells will slow down and eventually stop. Fourthly, there are diseases which may accelerate aging conditions like obesity and compromised immune system will accelerate aging. Obesity causes oxidative stress and inflammation, which may increase the rate of telomere shortening. In human studies, telomere length measured from our fat cells was significantly shorter in obese patients compared to never obese patients. Interestingly, it appears that physical activity may protect patients from telomere shortening due to obesity.
Damn, aging sucks, right? But is it all doom and gloom? While most older people suffer severely diminished endurance, there are some who complete marathons and even Ironman events. Ed Whitlock became the oldest person to run under 4 hours in 2016 at the age of 85. Fauja Singh, now 109, holds the record for the oldest person who ran a marathon. He completed the last marathon at the age of 100. So obviously, there are things that we can do to slow down and even reverse aging. In the next few weeks, we will review in the next 3 videos on how to reverse aging and look younger at any age. Stay tuned for the next video where we will talk about how sleeping better, managing stress, and stopping smoking can reverse aging. Like and subscribe to this video. Till the next time, stay safe and stay healthy.